So a lot of you have been asking about the Bren, and you want to see the Bren. So tonight, you're going to see the Bren. You want to tell us about the Bren, Jerry?
Yeah, that's the Bren Mark II. And there's not a lot of differences. One is its sight. The other Brens, they got a big dial sight, a really complex thing. This is a simple, the sights are off to the side. You can see because the magazine comes right out the middle on top. So you kind of got like peek around it. That's the way the British did stuff. They kind of, you know, looked around. But fantastic gun. Like we had the BAR. Heavy. This was theirs. Heavy as hell. It's heavier than the BAR. And it's got, it's got a dust cover here to keep the mag loose. You can change the barrel on the Bren, whereas the BAR you can't. That's an advantage. It's got this carry handle that, I can show you how, let me show you once how it moves into different positions. See, like right now it's a carry handle, or you can get it down like this, then it becomes a, you'll see them when they're walking around,
They're like that
with the Bren. You know, they'll have it on a sling, and it's got a dust cover, pops open, mag goes down in there. They're big honking mags, 30 rounders that stick up like this, and it's also got a dust cover here, covers all the whole bottom too. But the reason I never had a Bren until this year was ammo. The ammo was always shit. It was like hang fire, dud. You know, so you'd get a full auto Bren and it'd be boop, 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 you know. I mean, right. It wouldn't even run. But then my friend Sam Gabbert of SG Ammo in Oklahoma, pulled some kind of a deal. It was stuff that was for the Falklands War, because they still use Brens then, and it was in the early 80s, that ammo was new. Well, it was made in Germany, but it's fabulous ammo. I got a bunch of it. I said, I got to get a Bren.
You got to get a Bren.
Yeah.
And then I started asking about
Yes, Bren. About the same time. And so anyway, here it is.
Perfect.
So
see,
have to,
he got the Bren for me.
Yeah. But it's one of these guns that you can, the front sight just stays there. It won't move. You know, because most machine guns aren't like that. You know, they're wanting to, get away from you. But the Bren is really controllable.
Well, it's heavy.
Yeah, heavy honker. But they had these mounting points because they had a special Bren tripod that used to be almost free, but now they're like a grand to buy. Huh. And then they mounted them on Jeeps. They had Bren carriers. I put them on tanks. I know, and probably even airplanes. I don't know. But they mounted them everywhere. You know. Huh. And
Jerry, what year is this gun?
This is 42. Yeah, 42. And most of them were made during the war, and some after. But they're just, there's a reason. Anytime a gun stays in service for decades with a country, it's got to be for a reason, that it's good. Otherwise, they would have shucked it,
you know,
if there was problems. And they're good. So hoist that sucker, Lise.
I know. Oops,
sorry.
I mean, it's sucker's heavy.
Well, you're strong, but that'll test you.
Yeah.
And then put big mag in there, then it's even heavier. But it's just a cool gun. I don't have the bipod on right now, but I don't even know.
Do you have one?
Oh yeah, but I don't know if it's that great of a bipod because it, if you're in war and you have to lay down to save your ass,
right.
I suppose it's nice to have it. But we don't have to do that. So
right.
So you can shoot it from the hip. Hip, shoulder, or it'll drop on one of my tripods. Just drop right on there.
Shoot it from the hip.
Yeah, I know that's the way you want to do it. So
yeah. The only way to do it.
Yeah. See, grab that handle. See how that feels to you, off to the side. Yeah.
Yeah.
That is. Yeah. That's good. All right.
That is good.
Well, we're gonna have to get a mag out and do it.
Oh, I'm so glad you remembered.
Well, yeah, I'd remember.
All right. So this is the Bren Mark II. All right, here we go. The sucker's heavy. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, baby. That was real smooth. It had hardly any kick, probably because it is so heavy. Very nice.
Awesome, Lacey. Awesome.
Thank you.
No, the Brens are cool guns, They really are. But like the BAR, they're magazine fed, so they're empty all the time. You're constantly sticking mags in. And remember when you pulled it open, the BAR doesn't do this, but this has a bolt hold open, so it was locked back. So if you watch like film of the British back then, there was another guy laying next to it. They just kept popping mags in, they empty them, pop it up, pop another one in, spin it just ready to go right away, see? Because they're open, the bolt's already open.
Yeah.
You know, it locks back on the last round. Like the BAR does not do that. Because really that's the fair comparison, that we had the BAR and the British had the Bren. And they're similar guns, you know.
Huh. But this was developed like 20 years later, right?
Do you have the BAR here? So can we look at them side by side?
Yeah, we can do that. Yeah. The Bren is more so.
Oh yeah, the Bren is.
Yeah, the Bren's a meatier piece. But it was intended to be mounted on tripods and vehicles, whereas the BAR was always intended to be hand carried and shoulder fired. They're both neat, you know. I like them both.
Yeah,
you
I like them
do
both too.
Yeah. These BARs, I got a workout today. I got two of them here, and that one's so grimy, he quit working.
Yeah.
He needs a douche.
A douche?
A douche. Yeah.
He's beautiful.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Man, they are. I'm giving this one to Doug, the gift. Because they're so good. I made four for Mel, but anyway, they're so good because most 7-inch pistol barrels don't work very well on M16s. They're overgassed. They fry real quickly. You know, they don't last very long. These are like fabulous. These are like, they're made totally from parts. I mean, what you get is every little screw, this door is in pieces. You know, I mean, you just get a bag of parts, but that gets the cost way down. Then you just have to assemble everything, you know, forward assist, none of that's in there, you know. I mean, it's just raw parts, but these things work. And matter of fact, we're gonna put this on Doug's M16 and let it whirl. But they, because I've tried so many of these over the years, and they'll fry the gas tube, they'll break the bolt, they'll tear the extractor off, they'll stick in the chamber, because pistol barrels just aren't, it's hard to get the gas just right because they have such little room. There's the gas port, you can see the tube is only that long, so everything has to be perfect. Well, these are. So the speed is just right, it's fast, but the fireball is humongous.
Really?
It comes out. Oh yeah, but so for an M16, owner needs one of these uppers.
I need one of those.
Oh, I know you do. That's why I said I brought that up. And we agree. We are totally in agreement with that. So this one is going to Doug, but I'm sure that I can come up with one for you.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. And
because I'm your favorite.
Yeah. That's right.
Can we shoot it?
Of course.
All right.
Of course.
Yes. Ah. This is a special upper that my friend Jerry Levitt is going to make for me for my AR-15. It's a nice little short barrel. It's gonna have a great fireball. You ready? Fireball is like unbelievable. All right, hold on. Let me try to.
Mangled him.
I killed it. I think we're gonna have to go back to Hobby Lobby and get a new head.
You mangled him, Lace. You mangled that head. Very good.
That's nice. I absolutely have to have that upper.
I know. So I told you.
Yeah.
Well, I've messed with a lot of them, and most of them are just toys. They last a little while, then they're junk, or you get sick of fixing them. I've ran this for almost 2 years now. Yeah, I mean, a lot of rounds, probably.
I like the
20,000 or more.
Like I could see. I had to see through the fireball.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah, it's very good. Yeah, I'm glad you liked it. Yeah.
I do like it. I do like it. I can't wait to get mine.
Yeah, well, we'll do something about that.
This is a 12-gauge Sega, a true Sega.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a Russian Sega. It's not
fully
a knockoff.
Automatic.
Yeah. It's been converted to select fire, which on the, you know, the generally AKs are pretty easy to convert, but shotguns are not because they're just totally made different.
Right.
You know, they're the painstaking process to get it's robbed from Peter to pay Paul, and all the parts. The parts are all, they don't even look like the original parts anymore. But this gun works really good, and especially set up with this foregrip and this stock, fully adjustable. Almost anyone can shoot it. You know, I mean, just hang on.
Just hang on.
10 rounds is still, if you're going to dump that mag, 10's about all you want because it's, it's a struggle, but you're tough, Lace.
I'm tough. I can handle it.
You're tough as nails, so let it, get that monk.
You ready?
Yeah, get that monk.
You get that monkey?
Yeah.
Right. Hold on. Here we go. Ready?
Yeah. Excellent. Yeah, nice group, Lacey. Nice group. Yeah. Yeah, 10 rounds sure gets out of there in a hurry, don't it?
Yeah. I need to try that one again.
Yeah, very good.
That one knocked me back a little bit. All right. right, ready?
Got him!
Got him.
Wonderful. Wonderful.
Well, this one's up. Yep.
Yeah, they're a little awkward in food and take out. Excellent, Leaf. Excellent. Excellent.
That one didn't dog me back too bad.
What do you think of that Sega?
I love it.
It's fun, isn't it?
I love it, yeah.
It's total nonsense gun, but so fun.
Yeah, who cares about?
Yeah.
You know, yeah. People say, well, that's not practical. I'm like, who cares about
we
practical?
Don't.
I don't.
I know, I don't either. No.
Yeah,
no,
everybody just needs a full auto Sega.
Everybody giggles after they shoot it. I mean, everybody does. And if something can make you giggle when you get to be older, that's good.
That's good.
That's good. That's good, indeed. Yeah. Yeah, and especially, look at the whole pile. Yeah. Yeah, 20 rounds on a nice little cluster there. Very nice. And the debris field.
Yeah.
That was a lot of mess for a few seconds. Yeah. Who's going to clean that up now, I wonder?
The cameraman.
Yes, the cameraman. That's you.
That's you.
Well, we always have fun, Leif. Very
we
good.
Do.
Yeah, you carry it back.
Alrighty.
Yeah, it looks
Love
good
my
on
Sega.
You. It looks good on you.
It does look good on me.
Yeah, excellent.
This is interesting.
I don't know.
I don't think you got that bastard, Doug. My turn.
Got
All right, him. He's dead. Ooh. One in the chamber. That's why you
good.
Always check. The most dangerous gun is the one
the
you think is unloaded.
Tula threw some good. Tula threw excellent.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Jer. I'm good to see ya.
Yeah, see ya. See you later, alligator.
See you later, alligator.
Hey, you got a carry permit for that lady?
sure.